Let's move now to constructor. Constructors are also methods that we have in classes, and they are very critical when it comes to declaring objects. We will start with this example. We will assume the following. I will have public class student. I will have ID and GPA, they are private. I will have set student, which will take new ID, new GPA, save them in the private member. Get ID to return the ID, get GBA to return the GBA. We will also have the printing method to do the output of ID and GBA. Now, in the main method, if it says find the output of the following statement, student is T1 a new student, student is T2 new student. So what we are doing, we are creating two objects. ST1, ST2, and they are of type student. So each one of them will have ID and GBA. So it means I will have ST1 as an object, and I will should have ID and GBA. Similarly, I will have ST2 of type student, and I will have ID and GBA. And then directly it says, do the output of ST1 ID and GBA, ST1.print. So go and call print, do the output of ID and GBA of ST1. But we didn't initialize ST1 to any value. In the previous example, what we did when we created ST1, we have used setStudent in order to initialize the values. In this case, we didn't initialize any value, but directly we are asking do the printing, and similarly we are saying do the printing of the other object. If you compile and run this program, the output you will get as zeros because we didn't do any initialization. The compiler will initialize ID and GBA to zeros, to their default number. That's why if you need that your objects to have default value, such that whenever you create an object, you should have values in your object, then it means you have to add another method called constructor. So we will do the same exercise. I will have ID and GBA, I will have the set, we will have the get method, the printing, but we will add one more method, which is constructor. And this is, will be the new class we will have. So the same class student, I will add a method constructor, and constructor we can write it in two ways. I can have a constructor that is the default one, and always should be public, always should have exactly the same name as the class. So if the class is called a student, the constructor should be called a student, and I should have no return type. So it's not valid to say public void student, always we just say public student. If you have the brackets empty, this is default constructor, this is empty constructor, which means we have no parameter, and we will initialize ID to this value and GBA to zero. So it means go to the private ID, have it as 2017-01, go to the GBA and initialize it to zero. If you need values, then you can use constructor with parameters. Again, you should say public, you should say no return type, the name of the class, but you have parameters. So for example, you need value for ID, another value for GBA. So I will say long new ID, double a new GBA. What we are saying here, just like in the set method, we are saying ID equal a new ID. But when it comes to the GBA, because we know GBA should be having a valid value between 0 and 4, so I will have an if condition. So I will say if a new GBA below 0 or a new GBA greater than 0, then I will say invalid GBA and GBA should be reset to 0. Otherwise, I will say GBA equals the new GBA. Let's go and do the main method, and then we will see how can we call the constructor. So here from the main method, I'm having the following statements. I'm declaring ST1 of type student, and If you notice here, I have empty brackets, which means go and create ST1, and I should have ID and GBA. And at the same time, because I have constructor in my class, it means you have to go and call the constructor. So constructor is automatically called whenever you create a new object, only when you have a new object. So because here we have empty brackets, I will call the first constructor, the empty constructor. And what it says here, initialize ID and GBA to these values. So I will initialize ID to 2017, zeros and one, and the GBA to 0.0. So whenever we create an object, we need to call the constructor. And this is very critical when it comes to output questions, because always remember when you declare an object, call the constructor to have the initial value. Either all the calculation may get different values. Now I will need to create another object, ST2. Again, this ST2 of type student. So I will have again the same private members, which are ID and GBA. But this time we are saying new student, and between brackets I'm specifying values. So because we are specifying values, it means we should not go to the first constructor. I will go to the second constructor, which is constructor with parameters, and I will send the values. So the first value as a new ID, the second value 3.5 as the new GBA. So take the value of the new ID, save it in the ID. So ID will have 2017 and then 9s. GBA, I have an if condition. It says go and check the value of the new GBA is 3.5. Is it below 0 or greater than 4? It's not. So what I will have to mention, I'll have to say GBA equals the new GBA. So GBA will take the value 3.5. So it means if the value of the new GBA is valid, just take it. If it is not, we will do a reset. I have a third statement, ST3. Again, this is a new object, ST3. And I should have ID and I should have GBA. I have two values again, the new ID and the new GBA. Now, which constructor I have to go to? I have to go to the second one because I have values. So for this student 3. So for student 3, you will find that once you call the constructor, you will be sending that GBA as 99. So the GBA here should be as 99. And by this case, when it comes to the validation, and if you say new GBA less than 0 or greater than 4, 99 is greater than 4. So you will say invalid and the GBA should be 0. So the ID will take the value. We have no constraints over the ID. So the ID will be as it is. But when it comes to the GBA, because the initial value 99 is not valid, so it will be reset as 0. Now, when you do the output, ST1.print, ST2, and ST3.print, you will find the following values. The first one, because we didn't initialize it to any value, it will take the default values from the constructor. The second one, we have values and valid values, so it will take the values as initialized. The third one, because the GBA is not valid, 99 is not valid, so it will be within the if condition, it will be reset to 0. So this is an example of constructor, which is a special method you use in your classes in order to initialize the objects during the creation. So just to recap, remember that constructors are method that is called when object of the class is created by using the new operator. Just like if we say student S1 equals a new student. Constructor provides initial values of the instance, and constructor must have the same name as the class. So if your class is called student with capital S, your constructor also should be called student with capital S. And also constructor, it is defined like any other method, but remember you should not have return type. Remember that even void is not valid. We have two types of constructor, constructor with parameters and default constructor. A default constructor is a constructor without parameters, and it means that we just initialize the data members. So just like here, I have a data member ID and GBA. In my default constructor, I say ID equal GBA equal. If I have also name as a private member, I will say also name equal, what is the default value. And the thing that also we have to remember that if you do not define a constructor for your class, Java will define one for you. So, and it will, Java will define or provide a default constructor that is without parameter, and it will give you the default value. So this is the meaning of constructor and the concepts of constructors. As an exercise, try to write the following class. Create a class called employee. So it means I have to say public class employee. I should have three private members. So I should have employee ID, salary, and name. So I will have to have private keyword for each one of them, saying private long employee ID, private double salary, private string name. We have additional information here that for employee ID, the default is 101. Salary should be non-negative floating point and the default is 500. Name is a string and the default is no name. Remember, whenever the question is providing default values, these default values should be used with the default constructor. You should not just have them directly inside your data member, which means do not say the following. Do not say long employee ID, and this is declared as private, equals 1001. This is not valid. We are having default values within the question only for the sake that when you write your default constructor, then you can have the default values. Additionally, your class should have the following. Because you have methods, always remember to declare them as public. Default constructor. Default constructor, it means I should declare it as public. I should have no return type, and I have to give it exactly the same name as the constructor. So I will say public employee, the same name as the class. And then brackets, empty brackets. Inside the default constructor, I have to go for each data member, and I have to give it the default value. So I will say employee ID equals 101, salary equals 500, name equals no name. So these are the values that we have. Constructor with parameters for all private members. So it means you should have again public employee, but instead of having empty brackets, you will have three parameters, a new ID, new salary, and a new name, and you will do the assign. Just remember that when it comes to salary, we have an extra condition that salary should be as non-negative. So always it should be positive. So always I have to check if new salary is greater than zero or if it's not. And then as usual, we will have the set method, we will have get method, and we will have a printing method. So try to do this within your as an exercise, and I will upload the key solution as well. So you can refer to it and you can check your solution.